This case will discuss the positive externality in consumption and market failure. So positive externality in consumption means when someone's consumption affects others positively. For example, let us take that someone uses a light in front of his home on the street. So this street light will affect everyone positively. So this is, that means in this case what we will see, that private marginal benefit is less than social marginal benefit. So we can write that private marginal benefit plus marginal benefit equals to social marginal benefit. So in this case also, free operation of market will also cause market failure. There will be market failure if this externality is not addressed. That means the one person's behavior is affecting others positively, but the former is not being compensated or rewarded for his action. So here also, in horizontal axis we are measuring output, in vertical axis we are measuring cost and benefit. So this is our social marginal benefit curve and this is our private marginal benefit curve. And as there is no externality in production, so SMC equals to social marginal cost and private marginal cost will be the same. So socially optimum equilibrium point is ES and optimum level of output is OQS. But the private, the individual person will go by his own his equilibrium will be achieved here when private marginal benefit and social marginal benefit, private marginal benefit is equal to the private marginal cost. So EC is the equilibrium. So we call it another suboptimal equilibrium. So now we will find out the derivative loss here. So initially we give it A. So initially if we consider what is the, if the market equilibrium is ES, what will be the social benefit? So at ES, social benefit will be represented. This is the social marginal benefit curve. Output level is OQS. So social marginal benefit will be represented by the area of the quadrangle OAESQS. So OAESQS. And what will be the social cost? Social marginal, this is social marginal cost curve. The social cost will be OBESQS. So SC is OBESQS. But actually the market clearing level of output is OQC. So EC is the market equilibrium. So we have to find out what is the social benefit here, what is the social cost here. So at this level of output, whenever OQC is the level of output, social benefit, that means at point EC, social benefit will be represented by the area of the quadrangle OAMQC. And social cost will be represented by the area of the quadrangle OBECQC. So social cost will be OBECQC. So now we have to consider what is the decline in social cost and what is the decline in social benefit for producing at the suboptimal level of output. So here, what is the social cost? So you take that, you can take the difference between these two, SB here and social benefit here. So decline in social benefit is the area of the quadrangle QCMESQS. And what is the decline in social cost? The decline in social cost is QCECESQS. So delta SC equals to QCECESQS. So what we can find from there? The decline in social benefit is more than decline in social cost. So decline in, so this is the decline in social benefit and this is the decline in social cost. That means this is the additional decline in social benefit due to producing and suboptimal level of output. So this part we will call the deadweight loss. So we, in our words, that area of the triangle ECMES, this will indicate the deadweight loss. So that means here, for not producing at the socially optimum level of output, the entire society has to face a deadweight loss, MESEC. So this is the measurement of inefficiency, or we can say this deadweight loss indicates the market failure when there is the existence of positive externality in consumption.